the Byrd Ambulance Service. Byrd offers a multitude of services that are yours for the asking.
Can you tell me where else you seem to be hurt? Does this hurt when I touch here?
The Byrd Ambulance Service paramedics. Cool, calm, professional. The ambulance service transports invalid patients anywhere in the country. They take the deceased to funeral homes and provide hearses for funerals. The paramedics arrive for work at 8 o'clock. They wash the ambulances and they check the lights and sirens to make sure they are operating correctly. They put the proper supply of equipment on board to be ready for any medical emergency. A shift is 24 hours long. The paramedics become very good chefs. Recreation, the paramedics turn the garage into a basketball court. Working an entire day, they sleep and take naps in spare time. Once the ambulance service is notified by a funeral director of a location of a deceased, they remove the body to a funeral home in a respectful, dignified manner. Drivers fail to check rearview mirrors, the paramedics have a rough time getting to the scene. Watch on rearview mirrors at all times. As soon as you hear or see an emergency vehicle, pull off to the side of the road as soon as possible. Help save precious seconds en route to the victim's side.
This leg over here hurting you, Mike?
Okay, we want to cut these and get in here and take a look at your leg, see if you broke it or not.
Ma'am, the car gone right on the road.
Okay, now, Mike, the more you move around, the more it's going to hurt. Oh, you just remember that, okay?
Mom's here, honey. Yeah, I like mine.
That looks
yeah,
okay. Okay, let's get on. It'll probably start to feel numb. Probably won't feel any better.
Mike, we're gonna lift you up.
Just don't move for us.
In rough terrain, the paramedics provide the utmost comfort to the patient. The cot is lifted and carried the entire distance. Sandbags are used to further immobilize broken bones. The emergency medical technicians must give some people more aid, like our patients.
Hello, Mr. Elson. Having some chest pain?
Yes, thanks. Not too here.
Okay. Have you ever had this pain before?
I had a heart attack about 2 years ago.
Okay. Have you had any pain since then?
No. Just okay. Just till now.
What's the pain feel like?
Is
it like a heavy pain or is
it?
It's
heavy. It feels like it's pressing down.
Just like it's pressing down? Like somebody might be sitting on you, huh?
Yes.
Is that your wife you called on?
Yes.
Who is your doctor?
Before the paramedics can effectively treat a victim, vital signs including blood pressure and pulse are obtained along with the patient's medical history.
I'm going to check you out here. I'm going to put some electrodes on here and see what your heart's doing. Just unbutton your shirt here.
How long have you been having the pain tonight?
About an hour.
The paramedics function in accordance to a written set of orders from local physicians.
Wes, did you call the other car?
Yeah,
well, okay.
If either the patient's electrocardiogram strip or vital signs indicate a potentially dangerous condition, an IV is started. Then, if necessary, medications can be given directly into the vein, working more quickly.
Looks like ET.
We're going to put an IV on you, okay? And we're going to have some fluid running into you, okay?
Okay.
All righty. They bring the drug box up, Wes?
Yeah.
Okay. You said it was about 2 years ago that you had this?
About 2 years, yeah.
Okay. Okay, we're going to put this oxygen on there. Just wants you to breathe normally with it. It's about 5 liters. That's what you got.
Many victims of illness or injury have a reduced oxygen level in their system, so paramedics administer oxygen to many of their patients. In the case of the heart victim, oxygen will often help relieve the pain.
Can you squeeze your hand a couple times there for me? Have you ever had an IV before when you're in the hospital? I imagine you probably did.
Yes.
Okay, you're just going to feel a little sick.
Just breathe that like you normally would. Have you had much shortness of breath? Or?
Yes.
And how long has that been going on? Since the pain started?
Yes.
Okay.
Get all your vitals right.
Yeah.
The heart is monitored constantly because the injured heart can develop dangerous irregularities at any time. If the heart stops beating adequately to sustain life, the paramedics will begin cardiopulmonary resuscitation, a technique involving mouth-to-mouth breathing and external heart compression. If indicated by the monitor, they will also defibrillate the heart by sending an electrical current through the heart to make it contract normally again. Certain drugs are given to strengthen, speed up, or slow down the heart to reduce its irritability.
Okay, Mr. Elson, we're going to be moving you down to the car now. We're going to have our bed up here, and we'll just put you right on the bed and take you on down, okay?
Okay.
Okay. You're doing a lot better now.
His EKG showed a VTAC with a rate of approximately 200. And at that time, we started an IV of D5W and administered one bolus of lidocaine.
After completing their medical services to the patient, the paramedics prepare all equipment for another run. This film produced by Byrd Ambulance Enterprises, Mansfield. Filming and editing by Ronald Hicks. Speaking.